The Final Fantasy 16. Today we're going to the Naldian Narrow. And we're nearing the end of Final Fantasy 16. So I hope you guys enjoy. To the end.
There's a lot of sea between here and Walud, but any ship heading north has to round Zemeckis and put through the narrow. Maintain our current bearing north-northeast, and we'll catch the Black Galleon before she vanishes again.
What's to prevent her from circling around Ash from the south?
With these winds in those waters, it'd take them forever and a fortnight to reach Stonehear.
Mid knows what she's talking about, Clive. Better than any of us lot, anyway. I say we do as she tells.
Sails on the horizon!
She's ours!
Feel that,
Jill.
All hands! Battle stations!
Yeah, boys, let's go!
Let's see what this girl can do.
So does the other follow. The bond of consciousness which joins them condemning both to the same fate. Yet my every attempt to strike it from their hearts serves only to tighten its hold. Fascinating. There is naught my blade cannot sever.
To fight, eh? We go.
It's now or never.
I'll find her.
Bloody hell! Had a starboard!
both of you.
Jill!
You came!
Get back!
Clive, how did you...
I'll explain later. Pads!
Out of here I can.
Stand still!
Phoenix. Are you not the dominant of fire? I see naught before me but a guttering flame.
What?
But to where?
I don't know.
You. What did you do to Joshua?
Phoenix? Oh, I expect he will survive. This consciousness in which you coil your feeble souls is grown thick with desperation. And thus has my master turned to my blade. The world will soon be painted in black. And all that live shall gather in death's autumn wake.
Not if we remove the cause of this misery. Not if we destroy the last of the Mother Crystals and restore balance to the world.
Come, do you truly think it's so simple? The blight is inevitable. Not even the Almighty might stop its endless march. Your efforts will avail us naught. Naught, that is, but suffering. You must embrace the truth, Mythos. Accept your place with the Lord.
Keep
Mythos.
It. As long as there's a chance, there's a choice.
Ever led astray by your blind resolve.
It is time you learn the inevitability of your divine fate.
However much it may hurt.
Get as far away as you can.
Clive, no.
Trust me, Jill.
Oh, but we do. If only to remind you of your duty. Rise, Lithos. In the short time since our last meeting, you have grown much. Yet as a vessel, I fear my lord will still find you lacking. All this fire and fury, and for what? Stopping the blight. A foolish notion fed to you by a foolish man.
How dare you?
You know naught of this world nor of our place in it. If our fates were so easily rewritten, we would all be gods. Is the light of hope severed? You would yield so soon.
Never.
Life.
See, your iron will weighs you down, dragging you ever further from your purpose.
And what is my purpose?
Mythos, who are we? What are the dominants? The breath of the Creator still warm on our lips. We carry his light that we might guide the masses in his name. We are but mighty acts of God.
We are more than that.
You would be nothing without what he has granted you. The power we wield is his, and yet every time we draw upon it, it wears away at our very being. It breaks us. It unmakes us, that its immaculate aspect might reveal itself. The Icon. It is too much for even his chosen few. Apart from you, Mythos, you wield the might of many, yet your body does not answer for its avarice.
What are you saying?
What I am saying is that we dominants are a means to an end. We were created for you, that you might drink deep of our strength and thereby fulfill your divine purpose.
which is?
To feed. As you would know, could you only look beyond the walls of your prison of self-regard. As long as you choose to ignore this, you shall never penetrate my defenses. Still, you may take solace in the fact that you are not alone in your plight. The chains of volition shackle all of mankind, but there is yet cause to rejoice. For the Lord, in his mercy, has taken pity on his flawed creations, and shall see them restored to their proper forms.
And what exactly would that be?
Why, loyal servants to God? No.
Manners, Lord Rossfield? They are men, like you and me. Albeit ones unburdened by the wills that drive our kind to madness. They are pure. They are divine.
You mean to turn everyone Akashic?
Not turn, Muthos. Turn back. For too long has mankind been led astray by their clamorous wills. It is time they return to a world of quiet equality, where they might once more know salvation.
Salvation? And abandon everything we hold dear?
We don't need your salvation. We'll save ourselves, and we'll do it on our own terms. Not yours, and not your gods.
With every defiant expression of your will, the tighter the chains of consciousness become. But perhaps that fact may be put to use.
What?
Clive!
What?
The faster it binds you to the remaining dominance, the stronger your hunger will become. Until it leads you back to the only answer there ever was.
What?
Mayhap not by the path my master intended, but back all the same.
Ash is not far. I could freeze a path.
You're in no fit state.
Probably not, but I can try. Don't look back!
The others are safe.
The Enterprise was clear of the gap when we fell. They made it, Jill. And they will have seen the ice where it led. We need only wait till dawn. This is the second time Barnabas has bested me. I'm powerless against him.
Maybe there really is nothing else for it but to give yourself to his master.
You know what, Duma?
Only you won't do that. The Clive I know would never do that.
So you believe? But do you really know me? If
thought Barnabas said was true, then I'm more monster than man. And each time I summon the flames from within, I burn away the things that make me who I am.
Do you, though? Think of what you've used that power for. Of all the people you've saved. It doesn't matter how or by whom it was granted, only how you choose to use it. And you've chosen to use it for good, haven't you?
I've also used it to kill. What if that's my purpose? What if it's all I'm good for?
You're still that same boy I grew up with. Always so eager to save everyone around you, and yet always so low.
Always so eager.
Because you failed to realize the one thing that needed saving most of all. You, Clive. You. You never once took the time to save yourself.
Myself. I think I might be beyond saving.
No one is beyond saving. Provided they want to be saved. You fight to survive. And you survive so that you may protect those you love. It's what you do. What you've always done. And I know you're not about to change. So I'm going to help you. To give you what you need to protect us all.
Jill. Are you sure? If this is what you want, then...
This burden, I'll give you the strength to bear it alone.
But I'm not alone. These burdens I carry, my sins, my pain, my sorrow, I see now that they are all a part of me.
The power of Shiva. Find
find a way to save each other. That we might one day look upon the moon again, together.
And I promise you, Clive, that I will be there, no matter what you must become.
I know. I never thought a smile could bring me so much joy.
Eva!
What of Barnabas? Do we pursue him?
No. Our paths will cross again soon enough. Whether we like it or not. Besides, there is something we must do first.
Of course. Drake's spine. The last mother crystal.
The Einherjar is at the bottom of the sea. Walud won't dare move on Storm without her.
No, what?
But they know we're coming now. We'll need a plan, and a damn good one at that.
Then let's go home and find one. Ash will have to wait.
Oi, Sugars. Hey guys. On the next episode.